I always wondered what it was that made his horn talk like that. Each note said something, but I never missed their meaning. Even the advanced harmonic knowledge in some of his arrangements were usually left out of his own solos. But I know there was more to it than that. In January 1996, jazz lost a gifted man of many parts when Gerry Mulligan died. In addition to being one of the finest and most influential of all baritone saxophonists, Mulligan, born in 1927, was a composer of sublime melodies, an inventive arranger, and an engaging soloist on clarinet, soprano saxophone, and piano. Raised in Philadelphia, he specialized as a writer. His first recorded works were for Gene Krupa in 1947 and Claude Thornhill in 1948. He went on to successfully write for Gil Evans, Miles Davis, Stan Kenton, and all the meanwhile increased his performing reputation by organizing his popular quartet on the West Coast, which he shared frontline with Chet Baker, John Eardley, Bob Brookmeyer, and Art Farmer. He appeared with the Dave Rubeck Group from 1968 to 1972, and from 1974 he did annual tours with a quartet. Stan Getz said that in his hands, that cumbersome instrument took wing. Gerry Mulligan transposed both his instrument and his music into emotion. He allowed his listeners to touch and take hold of his sound. Gerry Mulligan lived 1927 until 1996.